Good morning, Davao. Good morning, Mindanao. Good morning, North, South, East, and West. This is Gilbert Lopez Martije Catso for the headlines. Weather forecast, easterlies affecting Mindanao. Local news, two trapped in Panabo Tunnel still missing. BTC Robo Aces overall runner-up in Philippine Robothon. Amit reputes claims of Kuya Gob Ubahib. Duterte disapproves preventive suspension order versus Ubahib. National news, Abalos orders LGUs to crack down on colorong vehicles. COMELEC ratifies creation of 8 new municipalities in North Cotabato. International news, Biden blasts Brazen's attack and backs Israel's security. Israel on high alert after unprecedented Iranian attacks. Entertainment news, Beyoncé's Cowboy Carters highlight the long history of Texas black cowboy culture. Cassie Legazpi on Real Score with Darren Espanto. Best friends lang talaga kami. And for the sports, McGregor or Conor McGregor versus Michael Chandler. Fight sets for 29 June at UFC 303. In Las Vegas. PBA Magnolias Lance Sangalan overcomes the challenge from Northport's Zab Lucero en route to career night. Featured stories, Thailand cooking rice dish to beat the heat. Beat the heat in summer in Anfanta, Quezon. Side stories and trivia. Do you know that Davao City is home to Philippine Women's College, one of the oldest universities in Mindanao? Weather forecast. Mindanao will have partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers and thunderstorm due to easterlies, light to moderate winds from east to northeast with slight to moderate seas. Local news, Panabo City Mayor Banjong Duhali III reported that two men who went missing and were reportedly trapped in tunnel in Purok Tres, Barangay Manay, Panabo City, Davao del Norte have been found yet. An interview with DXDC RMN mentioned a suspension of retrieval operations due to heavy rains that posed that to responders. The rescue team had pumped out water to continue the operation. Usa na kasi mana kung wala pa nakitaan tong mga patay nga lawas, posible nga nangalata na to. Dili na makitaan kay kabalo baya ta sa decomposition sa lawa sa tao. It has been a week if these bodies haven't or had not been found yet. They might have already decomposed. They cannot retrieve it anymore as human bodies decomposes. Said or he said. The search and retrieval team faced difficulties due to hydrogen sulfate in the tunnel. Based on investigations by Bureau of Fire Protection Panabo, BFP Panabo, the area contained around 36% flammable gas. The Broken Shire College of Davao, Turil Davao, BCT Robo Aces emerged as overall runner-up during the 9th Philippine Robothon at St. Paul College, Pasig City. Dan Gregory Alexis Murillo, Ace Gabriel Rugirog, Irogirog, and Aslani Marsanka clinched the championship title of the Mini Robotic Challenger under the senior category. Irogirog, in an interview with Sunstar Davao on Thursday afternoon, April 11, 2024, at BTC or BCT, said that their primary objective during the competition was swiftly develop and functional robot. He expressed surprise at their victory, especially considering that the robot was a standard of standard size. Mapansin man gyud nimo sa laing dako ilang robots pero hinay, mudagan, kay bugat man ilang weight. We noticed that other teams had larger robots that move slowly due to their weight, he said. Second District Board Member Orly Amit said that it is not true that Governor Edwin Cuya Gov-Hubahib is not aware of the complaint filed against him. Amit said in an online press conference on Thursday, April 11, 2024, that he does not believe that Hubahib is unaware of the case. He narrated that on July 17, 2023, after the Office of the President received his complaint, it immediately sent a letter to Hubahib asking to respond to the complaint. He said that around August 23, 2023, Hubahib received the order from the Office of the President on September 4, 2023. Hubahib sent a letter to the Office of the President asking for an extension to file an answer until September 22, 2023. However, Hubahib was unable to provide an answer and again asked for an extension to October 7, 2023. Then, by October 9, 2023, he replied to the complaint. Tataw kaayo nga ang due process ni Dagan ug dili tinuod nga si Governor wala nasayod ni ining kasuha. Kay katuluman siya nagsulat dito sa Office of the President. It is evident that due process was followed and it is not true that Governor is not aware of his case since he sent three letters on the Office of the President, he said. Former President Rodrigo R. Duterte P. FPRRD expressed his disapproval of the issuance of the preventive suspension order against Davao del Norte Governor Edwin Hubahib. He explains that the order directed towards Governor Hubahib requires investigation to ascertain any wrongdoing on his part. He said the official should not be or should be informed of the grounds and even the right to respond before serving a preventive suspension order. FPRRD also emphasized that Hubahib was elected by the people. So it is not right that he be removed from office by higher ranking officials. You must remember that governor or the governor of the North Davao is being elected by the people. Hindi yung trabahante na inappoint lang o inappoint mo tapos tanggalin mo. There's a big difference between an appointed guy and an elected guy. You have to respect the will of the people of North Davao. You must remember that the governor of North Davao is being elected by the people. He's not a worker whom you appointed and then removed. There's a big difference between an appointed guy and an elected guy. You have to respect the will of the people of Davao del Norte or North Davao. FPRRD said during a press conference on the evening of April 11, 2024. National News. Interior and Local Government Secretary Benhor Abalus has ordered local government units, LGUs, to prohibit operators of Kulurum Public Utility Vehicles, PUVs, from using transport terminal. Abalus also ordered LGUs to ensure that all public transportation services operating within their areas have permits. In a statement Saturday, April 13, 2024, the Department of the Interior and Local Government (DILG) said Abalos issued Memorandum Circular 2024-26 instructing LGUs through their councils to enact ordinances prohibiting Kulurum operators for using transport terminal. This has been a persistent issue on the ground. I am directing our LGUs na tiyaking hindi makapag-operate ang mga Kulurum operators na ito to make sure that these Kulurum operators can no longer operate, Abalos underscored. The DILG chief said operators must have obtained appropriate franchises or certificates of public convenience, CFC, from the Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board, LTFRB, before they can use transport terminal or ply roads. People in North Cotabato have approved through the plebiscite the creation of 8 municipalities in the Special Geographic Area, SGA, of the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region in Muslim Mindanao, BARMM. The Commission on Election said, in a statement, the COMELEC said, out of the total of 72,658 actual voters, 72,358 voted in the favor of the ratification of the new 8 municipalities, while 103 voted no. The pool body said 81.10% of the total voters from 63 barangays in North Cotabato participated the plebiscite. The 8 new municipalities are as follows: Pahamudin, Kadayagan, Nabalawag, Old Kabakan or Kaabakan, Kapalawan, Malidigaw, Tugunan, Ligawasan. The COMELEC said the conduct of the plebiscite has been peacefully and orderly, extending gratitude to the Philippine National Police, Armed Forces of the Philippines, and local government units. International news. U.S. President Joe Biden has praised American forces who he said helped Israel to take down nearly all the drones and missiles launching by the Iran on Sunday. In a statement, he said the U.S. have moved aircraft and warships in the region before the unprecedented attack. I condemn these attacks in the strongest possible term, he added. Israel said Iran launches hundreds of drones and missiles in its direction, the first time it has attacked Israel directly from its own territory. It says the vast majority were intercepted by there were a small numbers of hits, including at the IDF base in southern Israel. At least one person reported to be a young girl was injured. Iran has launched hundreds of aerial drones and missiles at Israel, marking a widely anticipated reprisal attack. It is the first such clash between the two enemies who had been engaged in a years-long shadow war, with Iran using the proxy forces. The Israel military said Israel and other countries had intercepted more than 300 cruise missiles and drones, mostly outside Israel airspace. Israel said very little damage have been done, but warned people to remain alert. Entertainment news. Anyone confused about Beyoncé's newest foray into a country genre has only to visit her home state of Texas to learn about black cowboy culture. Anyone confused about Beyoncé's newest foray into a country's music need only visit her home state of Texas to get a clear understanding of the link between the poof star or the pop star and a country and western vibe of her new album, Cowboy Carter. Though Beyoncé herself has said, this isn't a country album, it's a Beyoncé's album. It clearly draws from many sources, including the long history of a black country music and black cowboy culture. Texas and the singer's hometown of Houston in particular has long been associated with cowboys. The city, which hosts one of the largest rodeos in the world, the Houston Livestock Show and Rodeo, has undeniable cowboy credentials, as does the American or African American community in Texas and the greater American West. However, for a long time, the image of the cowboy has largely had a white face. Sparkle star Cassie Legazpi has spoken about her real relationship with its Showtime host Darren Spanto. Recently, Cassie gave a confident statement about her friendship with Darren. The Sparkle star said, "It's so hard to explain what we have, but we really are best friends." What Cassie said was consistent with when Darren said in a separate interview. Sports News. Ireland, Conor McGregor will return after almost 3 years out against Michael Chandler at UFC 303 in Las Vegas on 29 June. The former two-weight champion McGregor, 35, has not fought since July 2021 and has lost his first two fights. The UFC confirmed the welterweight bout with American Chandler following UFC 300 in Las Vegas on Saturday. McGregor has 22 wins and 6 defeats in his MMA career, while 37-year-old Chandler is 23-8. Pereira knocks out Hill to retain UFC title at UFC 300. McGregor broke a leg in defeat by Fury in his most recent fight in July 2021. He also lost to Fury by second round stoppage 6 months earlier. McGregor has won only once since becoming the UFC's first simultaneous two-weight champion at lightweight and featherweight in 2016. Chandler has been involved in some thrilling fights since moving from Bellator to the UFC in 2021, despite losing 3 of his 5 bouts. He lost to then champion Charles Oliveira in his second UFC fight before defeats by Justin Gaethje and Fury. The McGregor-Chandler matchup was confirmed but no set date early last year when they were opposing coaches in the UFC's Ultimate Fighter reality. Northport's Zab Lucero gives Magnolia Lan Sangalan a hard time in compiling his career high offensive output in their PBA Season 48 Philippine Cup skirmish on Wednesday, April 10. With Magnolia reeling from 2 straight losses, Lan Sangalan felt a sense of urgency to step up for his team. He delivered a big time. Sangalan fired a career high 32 points and held down 13 rebounds as the Hotshots eked out a 104-97 win over Northports in the PBA season's 48 Philippine Cup at the Ninoy Aquino Stadium on Wednesday, April 10. Putting up a tour de force against the Batang Pier was not a walk in a park for Sangalan, thought no thanks to counterpart Zab Lucero. The features. The sweltering heat during Buddhist New Year caused for Thailand cooling khao chai, a fragrant and refreshing bowl of rice delicately scented with flowers. By the time Songkran Thailand New Year based on the Buddhist calendar arrives in April, the temperatures in the Southeast Asian countries are soaring. The sky is typical blue and spotless. So, reprieve under the shade of a passing cloud is non-existent, while the humidity is as thick as a fleece blanket. One way to cool off is in the countrywide water fights that takes place during the annual celebrations. This year from 13 to 15 April, which include water guns, buckets and colored powder smeared onto the face like war paints. Another way to celebrate the cool off is to eat cow chai. Cow chai, sook rice, is an icy or seasonal treat that marks the beginning of summer in Thailand. The history of the dish can be traced back hundreds of years ago or years to the Moon people, an ethnic group that originated throughout Myanmar and Thailand and integrated into what was the Siamese society in the 16th century. Just a 3-hour drive from Quezon City, passing through Antipolo and Marilac, you'll reach the town of Alfanta in Quezon Province. At Cacawayan Falls, you'll be greeted by a pristine waterfall with a strong rush of water. The water is crystal clear, surrounded by lush greenery of towering trees. There's also a pool area for kids, making it perfect for the entire family. And the best part, entrance fee is only 50 pesos. Sulit na sulit sa 50 pesos, sobrang lamig, sarap, sobrang sarap, presko, said Juby Christian Spirito. The 50 pesos entrance fee is worth it. It's so refreshing and cool. Mag-i-enjoy kayo. Di naman ganun kalamig. Mangangatog ka lang, said Justivi Alicandro. You'll definitely enjoy it. It's not too cold, but it will leave you shivering. Agus River in Infanta, Quezon Province. For the side story, let's watch this. And of course, our trivia. Do you not know that Davao City is the home of Philippine Women College, one of the oldest universities in Mindanao, known for its excellent educational programs and strong emphasis on women empowerment? The college has been the catalyst for change in the region. That's all our news for today. Please like, share, subscribe, and click the bell button for you to be updated of the news of Pinoy Rob News Channel. This is Gilbert Martihi Lopez Cazzo. Good morning.